And more kids who have grown up find themselves taking care of their elderly parents and grandparents at home.
8,000 of them are turning 60 a day. We need some help here, so we called in the big guns today. Dr. Marion.
Well, if you find yourself caring for an aging parent or other loved one, this guide might be a very good resource. Dr. Marion Summers has written Elder Care Made Easier. She's one of the top elder care experts in the country.
I want to wake up America. I'm trying to get to people and have them be proactive so that they start thinking about these issues before a crisis happens. It's very important for us to stay in touch with our elderly relatives at all times. I've been dealing with the elder care issue for over 30 years, right. And during that time I've learned an enormous amount and I want to share it.
NBC News In Depth tonight. We continue our special series, Trading Places, on taking care of aging parents. This week we're looking at your stories. And one of the things that has come up in the well over 5,000 emails and pictures we've received on this topic, the issue of long-term care insurance.
Yearly premiums can run you anywhere from around $1,000 to several thousand dollars, depending on your age and the options you choose.
Dr. Marion Summers is a geriatric care manager in New York.
There are four factors I ask people to address. One is the benefit factor, one is the waiting period factor, the amount factor, and inflation.
Hello, this is Dr. Marion, author of Elder Care Made Easier. Long-term care insurance should absolutely become a part of an insurance portfolio for anyone over 55 years of age. I realize that nobody has a crystal ball, but long-term care insurance may take care of extraordinary needs of an elder in a health crisis. Most long-term care insurance policies activate the moment the need is there and then cover hospital, home care, aids and other costs to supplement other insurance or Medicare that's available. Some policies have a component that allows a geriatric care manager to do an initial assessment and then put it into place. Some policies even offer a lump sum payment you can spend as you see fit. So be proactive. Long-term care insurance is well worth it and can save the day.
For more elder care info, visit Dr. Marion online at drmarion.com.
I say communication is king, and I truly believe it. You can't say to the older person, you got to do this because this is what the lawyer says, this is what the financial advisor says. You know, you're using logic. Logic does not count when you're dealing with emotion. So what I say, and I get very dramatic, I say, this is killing me. I can't keep up with my life. I am just at my wit's end. I just don't know what to do anymore. And then the older person comes to my rescue.
I like the way she's light. She doesn't make it feel heavy. There are things you can do. Ways you can be, you know, and she puts that out there.
It's like a coach. if you have a problem and you're doing something, and she can look at it and say, this is what you can do to make this better.
If people have a need, I simply address the need as straightforward as I possibly can. I've had enough experience to know that there is an answer for everything. Sometimes we have to be creative in the answer, but the answers are always there.
I drove through the desert to Phoenix, Arizona, where I spoke with seniors committed to staying active and independent.
My house 2 years ago, even though I don't need it yet.
And how did you seniorize it?
I put a ramp on my patio. I put a ramp into my house. I put bars in my 3 bathrooms.
I love you.
When people anticipate the needs, they're just saying, I want to be healthy and active for as long as possible.
I think none of us want to realize that we're getting old. And I think, I'm 76. No, I'm not 76 yet. Yeah, I am. But I don't feel like I'm 76. And I want to keep it that way as long as possible.
When I see people doing these things, I want to just hug them and cheer them on and congratulate them for being proactive, because they are enabling themselves to be as fully functioning as they are capable of. I only have one life, and I'm going to make the best of it. And when somebody is proactive, they are saying, I'm going to make the best of this life that I have been given until the day I don't have a life to give. And that's a message seniors can live by and a legacy they can pass down to future generations. Next week, I'll be back with more of my journey across America.
I'm in Iowa to talk to the presidential candidates and find out how are they going to deal with this geriatric tsunami that's heading this way. We have at least one-third of the population is going to be over 55 in this next decade. The demographics are going to alter how we deal with each other and how we deal with our elderly.
There's no reason that we should have a setting where people should not have confidence that health care and Social Security will be there.
The resources are out there, but the combination of getting the resources to the people seems to be missing. And I wanted to know, are they dealing with this? Are they addressing the issue? Are they aware of the issue? I feel I've come to Iowa to shake the candidates in America by the shoulders and just tell them that this is not going to go away.
Oh, you know, we just have to do a plan that takes care of Medicare, does long-term care insurance. You know, we just got to get on it, otherwise it's going to hit us in the face.
We have to address this. It's a monumental issue. It's not just in this country, it's going to happen across the world. And how are we going to deal with it? Let's come up with some answers that are practical, that are doable. Let's support the elderly. Let's support their caregivers who are falling apart. They're really fraying at the seams across America. They need support. They need to know that they're not alone. And we can help them. We are a country of ideas and innovation, and we need to be very innovative as to how we deal with this very unique problem that no country in the world has ever had to deal with, no generation has ever had to deal with this issue before.
Sometimes I get so tired.
A year ago, my dad lost eyesight in one eye. And then a couple months ago, he lost eyesight in the other eye. That really changed their world.
If I get worse and worse and worse, I may eventually be completely blind.
I have my own family. I have a full-time job. And now they have needs. They can't get out of the house by themselves anymore. They need me. They need people to help them.
Don't wanna waste another day.
I came into this situation, it was a heartbreaker.
I don't know how I can do it all. My kids need me, my husband needs me, my parents need me, I need me. There's not enough of me to go around. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I need help. We all want to have some faith.
At least that's true in my case. Dr. Marion Summers is a geriatric specialist and the author of Elder Care Made Easier.
Dr. Marion is here.
Dr. Marion Summers.
Marion Summers.
NBC News In Depth tonight. We continue our special series, Trading Places, on taking care of aging parents.
I'm so glad you're here.
This was a household that needed a great deal of help. First thing I had to do was get them to start talking to each other. They did not know how to communicate their feelings.
We get together once in a while, but there's no love, really. There is no love.
If you guys don't change your attitude, I can't deal with the emotions.
But what are we supposed to do? We have to turn to our children. They're our family.
I've done enough for my kids when they grew up. They have the responsibility of helping us.
You've got to think about what comes out of your mouth, because that's what's hurting me and it's going to push me away. She's not getting any clue that we're doing all this for her.
She's pushing herself to many things.
But one of those things that she is pushing herself in is making sure that her parents are safe.
Oh, you're doing a Herculean job.
They had to understand that all emotions were valid and they needed to listen to the other person's point of view. This world may crumble into the ocean. It could all end tonight. This is so exciting. I've got adapted equipment into the household. I've got the family using the adapted equipment.
To me, they're like a friend. They're always there to help me.
Gail is taking better care of herself. The whole family is communicating in a way that they did not know how to do before.
I love you, and I'm not going to hate you for if you make a mistake.
Dr. Marion, help us come together, be a family, be united as one, and really make this effective for all involved.
To be able to see how people change right before your eyes is just a thrill beyond belief. Fear, frustration, and anger were replaced with acceptance, peace, and safety. I know there's something.